All right, let's talk about an age-old question in the community, something that I get personally asked about a lot, and that is, how powerful is Boros in his armored form, or armored Boros, or base Boros, whatever you want to call him. And it's a pretty intriguing question because, you know, why not? We know how strong he is in his released form and, of course, in his meteoric burst form, but how strong is he at base level? So, granted, we haven't seen him in combat, really, aside from getting punched, which, of course, we're going to be talking about, in his armored form, so it's really up in the air, and your opinion on this is just as valid as mine, but I do think we can kind of come up with a reasonable answer to this, and I'm just going to go over all of the evidence and info that we have and cross-compare some stuff. So first of all, let's just go into Boros as a person, or as a being, as an alien, whatever you want to call him. So we know that his species survived the struggle for existence on a very harsh planet. Like, the images that we see of it, there's like volcanoes everywhere, there's fire raining from the sky. He's pretty much living in hell, like every single day. So they've overcome all of these harsh environmental factors for however long in order to evolve into this crazy powerful species. They're like, I guess, the Titans of the One Punch Man world, you know, like Thanos' race, the Titans. We also know that they possess the greatest natural healing in the universe. Take that for what you will. You know, because we know that Boros and the Dark Matter Thieves are kind of hyperbolic with their achievements and whatnot, because, you know, Garugan Shoup said that he was the greatest psychic in the universe, and we know that that's probably not the case. But regardless, it's still pretty darn impressive. But on top of all of that, Boros has the greatest healing, physical performance, and potential energy of his entire race. So I think this is also drawing more parallels to Thanos, because I guess it was implied that Thanos was like the greatest Titan, more or less, at least in the MCU, I guess, I don't know. But regardless, Boros is insane. He is super powerful. He is the dominator of the universe for a reason. And the whole thing that we're talking about with his armor, he's wearing that to just nerf himself because he is so incredibly powerful. So let's get a little more into that armor, because it's kind of important for the question at hand here. So Boros himself says that the armor holds in his overwhelming power. So I guess it's like shutting off the kinetic energy or whatever kind of energy that he is producing here when he's outside of it. And with that being said, it doesn't really seem like the armor is for any kind of protective purposes. I mean, I'm sure it's durable, you know, because it's Boros and I'm sure he has high grade stuff. Just based off of him saying that it holds in his power, I don't think he's wearing it to, like, protect him from outside forces. Because, you know, he's Boros, he doesn't really need, like, armor. It's more so just to hold in his energy. So that brings us to the punch. This first punch that Saitama delivers to Boros when they first meet. And this is, like, the most important thing that we could go off of to really gauge how powerful Boros is in his base form. So, that being said with everything else, I don't think that the armor helped Boros take this punch. Now, maybe like a little bit, like a tiny bit possible, but still, this punch wrecked Boros. Regardless if he has the armor on or not, like, we see his reaction to getting punched, he's like, oh crap, it sends him far back, right into that pillar, breaks it up, and Boros is like, it looks like he's incapacitated for like a second, maybe he knocked him out, like, a moment or two, I don't know, but him getting up from this and his armor breaking surprises Saitama. And I think that kind of dispels any notions that people have of implying Saitama was holding back in this moment. I don't think Saitama was holding back. Yeah, I mean, sometimes he is, but I don't think in this case. We've seen that he just more or less wants to get the job done against monsters and whatever other aliens and whatnot, because Boros has also already committed genocide at this point, so he's unredeemable. It's not like Saitama's trying to have a fun time with him. So I don't think he would be surprised by Boros surviving the punch if he intentionally held back, expecting him to get up. You know what I mean? But regardless, it's still pretty darn impressive that Boros is able to survive this punch. I mean, regardless of the intention of it, any monster that takes a punch from Saitama and gets up from it, still in one piece, still conscious, if anything, shows that he's one of the strongest monsters. Because we saw Carnage Kabuto, before this was probably the strongest monster that we have seen, or just kind of, I guess, couldn't take one punch from Saitama, and it didn't seem like the punch that he gave to Carnage Kabuto really had any more effort to it than the punch that he gave to Boros. It doesn't seem like there was any more killing intent behind it, I'll say. Because the other example that we could go off of is Saitama against Orochi, who is another super powerful monster who's definitely above dragon. And it seems like Saitama was definitely trying to kill Orochi with that punch that he delivered through his head. So it's hard to say if that was on the same level that he's giving to Boros here, but regardless, I think that they both have killing intent behind them. Also, speaking of Orochi and Carnage Kabuto, just like them, Boros is able to sense Saitama's energy, although he seems to have a better understanding of this than them. In Carnage Kabuto's sense, it was him saying that his survival instincts were telling him that Saitama is super dangerous. And with Orochi, it's not really made too clear. He's kind of just aware that Saitama is no joke. But Boros seemed to actually be able to comprehend the immeasurable energy coming from Saitama. So before I go into my conclusion, I just want to touch on one thing real quick, and that's the certain group of people that think that Armored Boros is a planet buster just as is. So people think this because of the compost, the little companion guide that we get with the One Punch Man Blu-ray. This book doesn't really mean much. It's just a transcript of everything that we see in the anime. It's not written by one. It's just written by somebody that works for the company, I guess. Who knows? It could have been anyone that wrote this. But all of the information coming from this book is what you can just see or hear in the anime. That's it. So for the section on Boros, we see the first page has him in his armored form, and then we have like a summary of text next to him. And it's just summarizing his character. That's it. It's not giving us any deep cuts or kind of new information that we didn't already know about. But in this little thing of information, it's telling us, you know, about his species, the regenerative stuff, everything that we already know. And then it says, along with latent energy so powerful that it can destroy entire planets. And people just, I don't know, for some reason, just link this to Armored Boros being able to destroy entire planets just because he's on this page. But this is just because we know, because he says this. They're just talking about him in the meteoric burst form doing the collapsing star roaring cannon. Also, shout out to Scumridge on Reddit for even supplying us with these images of the compost. But yeah, that's all it was. It wasn't saying that Armored Boros can destroy a planet. It's just saying that he has latent potential to destroy a planet because he does. He says that he does when he's in his meteor burst form. So now let's go to the actual data book, you know, the one that was actually written by one and has some deep cuts on the character. So this doesn't really give us any new info on Armored Boros, except that his height is 7 feet 8 inches tall, or 2.4 meters, which is pretty tall. But it's giving us his disaster level, which says dragon. So we all know the whole thing about when one was asked what his disaster level was in an interview, he said dragon or above or equal to or greater than dragon. But in the data book, it simply just says dragon, and this is coming from one. So this could mean that just Boros, when he comes down to Earth, you know, in his armored form, is considered to be disaster level dragon. And that when one was asked in the interview, he was saying dragon or greater or equal to dragon, meaning that after his armor comes off, then it's up in the air. Then he's greater than dragon after that point, meaning that he likely goes to above dragon, you know, the term that we associate to characters of that power level. And then maybe after Meteoric Burst, he's approaching God or whatever. So let's just backtrack from Meteoric Burst all the way down to Armored, and I think that might give us more or less what we're working with there. So if we say that Meteoric Burst is close to God level or on the level of God, whatever, we're going back to released Boros, who I think we can determine is definitely an above dragon level threat. But we see the discrepancy in power between these two, because while he's in his released form, he's giving Saitama the most competitive fight we have ever seen. Super fast, super strong, has the energy blasts, but then when he goes to Meteoric Burst, that all just goes to the next level. Like, so fast that he is literally surprising Saitama with his speed. The energy blast, the regeneration, everything just goes up a level. So if we go below released, we could just try to guess what his speed would be like. It's just a slower form of what he's like in his released. You know, if we're just comparing the increase that the released gets from going into Meteoric Burst, if we kind of try to use the same percentages just in our mind to decrease it into his armored form, then we can kind of see that he's as fast and as strong as, like, just taking a guess here, maybe Carnage Kabuto, maybe like a stronger form of that, you know, considering that he can actually take a punch from Saitama and Carnage Kabuto can't. So if Carnage Kabuto is like a high dragon, which he very likely is, considering that he can push Darkshine to his limit for 15 minutes, he's likely a high dragon there. So if we're looking at a similar set of skills that Boros has, because they, you know, they're very similar in their fighting style, they're just very physical, super fast, you know, punching type style, then I guess he's like a stronger version of Carnage Kabuto, but not quite as strong as his released form. So I guess this means that he's like a really high dragon, or maybe the highest of the high dragons. Like, he's as strong as a dragon can get before going into above dragon. Maybe that's possibly where Armored Boros sits, you know, but he's also, we can assume that he's losing the ability to shoot the energy blasts that released Boros has, because, you know, the whole armor is restricting that and everything. So I'm just assuming that maybe he's like a stronger version of Carnage Kabuto with the ability to regenerate, more or less. So yeah, that's pretty much it, I guess. I mean, I tried, guys. It's super subjective, especially with this, considering that the only feat that Armored Boros has is just taking a punch from Saitama and sensing his energy. So like I said at the very beginning, your guess is just as good as mine, but I hope that this video is at least entertaining. Maybe it gave you some insight that you didn't originally have, but regardless, let me know what you feel Armored Boros' power is, you know, what he could be, who is he comparable to? Carnage Kabuto, maybe? I didn't go into webcomic spoiler stuff in this video because I don't really have to, but if you want to in the comments, go ahead. But aside from that, if you liked it, please give it a like. I also have a Patreon, gives you access to a weekly Q&A video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe as well. Have a great day. See you in the next one.